You take the precious people. But what you assure Thank you. leaders, out of teachers, out of mentors. He wants this person that will represent him. You know, in character, in power. When people see you, they should see God. When people hear you, they should hear God. But I want to assure you, it will not just happen. You have to be consecrated. You have to spend your time with God and allow God to whisper to your ears. Allow God to shape you. Whichever way He decides. Come and take a position of breath. Don't compare yourself with anyone. And you are going to leave us every to hear Him. But I can assure you, you are too faithful to leave me. You are too faithful to leave me halfway. Umeanza na mimi, umeita, you have separated me, and you know you're taking this shower for the glory of your name. And therefore, you cannot afford to miss out to escape the molding process. Because if you go to those leadership positions, if you go to those responsibilities, and you are not completely molded, you're going to leak, as I say. Some of these responsibilities are going to break us. You know, they are going to make us put under our depression. Why? Because one thing in our mind, you have to fix space. If you look at your strength, are you really able to handle? Praise the name of the Lord. And because God knows each and every one of us, He knows us, He knows your strength, He knows your ability, He knows His your weaknesses. And therefore, whatever way He decides to hold you, allow Him because He's faithful. Ministry chapter 25, all of you wish your life. I mean, if I put your life prayer, you take a lesson from my prayer that I'm a channel, you can take a Mungu to be a good and a Mungu. You know, I want to do things in the near future, and I can stand and tell people, I don't care. Because most of the people nowadays, they are running for those big positions. They are running for those responsibilities. They are running for those big names. But when you go there, you become unstable. Let me show you how many people think very well, and at some point you run away, and then disappear too. It is because they don't have the muscles to carry on. They don't have the muscles to proceed. They don't have the muscles to hold. But they pray in Jesus' name. But because of the cycle of greatness, may you allow God to hold you. He knows what you can bear. And I can see great future leaders. I can see them. And I pray that God will hold you to the design He wants. You know, to the style He wants. Depending on where He's taking you. Because if you can have people who are fully met, then you have ministries that are standing. We will have families that are standing. We will have leaders that are not compromised. Because it is about the process. Don't be deceived simply because you woke up one morning and you started singing and you thought I can now start a ministry. My goodness. It will not happen that way. You need to sit under a man of God. And that is why I encourage people, stay without mentors. I tell everybody, be under mentorship. Because God will use people to mold you. God will speak through people to shape you. As much as God will speak through situations and circumstances, He will use people. Who are you looking up to? You need to be seated under someone, a man of God, a wise man of God, an intelligent man, who will tell you this is not the way. And you'll be ready to hear. So I pray that you as God molds us, may we be patient. May we be there. Scripture says in Psalm 46, verse 10, be still and know that I am God. Being still means being patient. Staying there until He tells you this is the time. This is the way. But most of us are not patient. They are not still. They are making ways for themselves. They are looking for shortcuts. And the moment you look for a shortcut, you get what you call a counterfeit blessing. Something that looks like the original, but it is not. You may even be in a position that was not meant for you. So I pray that we are now God to hold us. You don't want to be a pot that has a very nice flower place for you when it is leaking. Because you have very big potatoes, you have very big industries, you have very big leadership positions. But we are leaking. You may have leaders that are most compromised. Yeah, you may have leaders that are people who are falling off the And I pray that this person will be you. I pray that this person will be me. The way people hear you, they hear God. The way people see you, they see the character of God in you. See, Mama, I can listen to who you are talking. See, Mama, I can question. You know how these people are here trying to get of pastors and ministers? You just give a Bible and you start a ministry half paid, and then you start to give a benefit. You make people to be more pastors and like this. They are men of God who are serving. They have gone through tough times. They have been molded, either through the word, mentorship, or any other way that they are standing. So I pray that you allow God. May God shape you. He knows you. He knows your destiny. He knows what He had in mind when He created you. Scripture says that He said, let us create a man. So when He created you, He had something in mind. And I want you to understand that your work in progress. How is that coming? Kabla uwe kwa hatima yako, kuna kazi Mungu anafanya kwa maisha yako. Kuna kazi Mungu atatumia watu kuifanya kwa maisha yako. May you be teachable in Jesus' name. May you be receptive in Jesus' name. The way people are sent, the way to correct you, you have to shape it. When situations come, may you be stable. May you ask for grace to push, to carry on, so that you see your destiny as a strong man in Jesus' name. It is my prayer that you allow God to show us. He's too faithful. He will take us through. Because we want to see ourselves as those people that God wants us to become in the near future. It cannot be through any other way, but through allowing the process to be complete. Allow God to shape you, allow God to mold you, so that you stand with this strong person that God intended. Let us pray. I thank you, Father, even for the wonderful time that you've given us to share your word. Thank you because you're shaping us. Your holiness with these people that you had in mind when you created us, O God. May you give us the grace to persevere. May you give us the power to wait, that all the way you may come up to these people that you intended in Jesus' name. The way we stand, O God, we shall represent you in character, in speech, and all around for the glory of your name. We give you glory and praise in Jesus' name. So God bless you as you help us to wait, as God shapes your destiny in Jesus' name. Shalom.